Castillo, and the entire faculty and staff of St. Catherine of Alexandria, I would like to welcome you, each of you, to the 2021 National Junior Honor Society Recognition Ceremony. In recognition of our commitment to citizenship, character, leadership, scholarship, service, and in making differences, large and small, it is with great pride that we receive mementos, which we hope will serve as lifelong reminders as the principles for which the National Junior Honor Society and St. Catherine of Alexandria stand for. As we do for all important events at St. Catherine, we will begin with a prayer. Let us begin our prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Lord God, you call us to a life in all of its fullness, following the path set out by Jesus, your Son. As we reflect on his leadership as servants, we ask you to deepen our desire to imitate his example. May our exercise of the gifts you have given us to be a faithful reflection of his presence at work in our lives. We make this prayer to you through Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please remain standing for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please be seated. Next, Brian Sock will speak on the requirements for membership and the symbolism of the lighting of the candles.
At St. Catherine, there are four steps which must be completed in order for a National Junior Honor Society candidate to successfully reach and maintain their goal of membership. The four steps are as follows. First, a student must maintain a grade point average of 3.5 or higher. Second, a student must complete 24 hours of service, 12 in school and 12 out of school, although this requirement was waived this year due to the pandemic. Next, a candidate must receive final approval of St. Catherine faculty and staff. And finally, throughout the entire school year, the student must follow the NJHS requirements as they pertain to these five pillars. First, service, a commitment of volunteering time. Second, citizenship, a commitment to protect the freedoms and rights that have been granted to us and prevent injustices from entering our lives. Third, leadership, a commitment to leading class in school. Fourth, scholarship, a commitment to ongoing inquiry and learning. And fifth, character, a force within each individual which distinguishes that person by bringing self-respect as well as respect for others. The students here today have diligently worked on all aspects of the five pillars, and today we are recognized for our hard work at this recognition ceremony. At this time, I invite the deputies to come forward to present the largest candle. The lighting of the candle is a meaningful part of our recognition ceremony. The largest of the candles symbolizes the eternal light or lamp of knowledge.
Character is the force within the individual that distinguishes each person from others. It creates for each of us our individuality, our goodness. It is that without which no one can respect oneself, nor hope to attain the respect of others. It is this force of character that guides one through life, and once developed, grows steadily within. Character is achieved and not received. It is the product of constant thought and action. The daily striving to make the right choice. Power of character is the power of self-control. We must be in reality what we wish to appear to others, to be rather than to seem. By demonstrating such qualities as respect, responsibility, trustworthiness, fairness, caring, and citizenship, we may hope to prove by example that we are valued character.
Leadership should exert a wholesome influence on the school. In taking initiative in the classroom and school activities, the real leader strives to train and aid others to reach their common goals of success. The price of leadership is sacrifice. The willingness to yield one's personal interests for the interests of others. A leader has self-confidence and will go forward when others hesitate. No matter what power and resources may exist in a school, community, or nation, they are ineffectual without the guidance of a wise leader. Leadership is always needed. Thus, to lead is a meaningful charge to each of our members.
Service can be established in the routine of a day's work where many opportunities arise to help others both at school and in the community. A willingness to work for the benefit of those in need without monetary compensation or public recognition is the quality we seek in our membership and promote for the entire student body. We are committed to volunteering our time and talents to the creation of a better tomorrow.
Our seventh grade members will now receive their certificate and pin. Leilani Amaro. Madeline Connolly. Daniel Primes. Martin Donahue. Katie Ferguson. Ava Kruger. Michael Harmon. Kevin McCurdy. Thomas Murphy. Joseph Phillip. Bridget Reynolds. Emily Roman. Abigail Ryan.
Congratulations.
Michelle Scott. Mackenzie Smith. Lucy Byrne.
Congratulations.
Sabrina Fons. Joseph Hall. Nolan Leonard. Gia Lombardo. Bridget Norcom. Marissa O'Brien. Michael O'Connor. Gabrielle Ramirez. Madeline Starson. Annalise Tortora. Congratulations to all of our seventh grade members. And now the eighth grade students will be presented with their honor cords. Earning this symbol of honor has been challenging, and their goals have required sacrifice and fortitude, but they have pushed themselves to achieve this accomplishment. Eighth grade members have earned the privilege of wearing these cords on graduation day to recognize their dedication and achievement. Grace Bonham. Emma Bushko. Brendan Kern. Catherine Dunning. Reagan Gallagher. Bridget DeFano. Brian Sack. Thomas Doherty. Krista Klonowski. Lauren Brannis. Megan Hansen. Luke Nowakowski. Gabriella Scala. Brian Spellman. Nora Swatinski. Addison Glenke. Charles Withers. Nadette Burns. Congratulations to all of our eighth grade members of the class of 2021. Come forward for the closing prayer.
please rise. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Lord God, the work of our hands, our minds, and our spirits, may we constantly reflect the work of thy kingdom. Grant us the courage to go forward today and willingly embrace the mantle of the servant, knowing that as servants of God, we will share the fruits and joys of thy kingdom. That is, and is to come. We ask this through the one who came to serve, Christ our Lord. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Thank you for supporting us and joining us in this memorable celebration.
And I invite Father Fred to come forward for the final blessing. Spirit.